All right, Coach, talk about the transition to 3-4 and multiple fronts, I guess.
There you go, multiple fronts. It's been really good. Our guys are enjoying it. We think it, you know, make the offense have to be off balance a little bit. So still being able to be a multiple front, they got to work on a lot of different things, our opponents I'm talking about. So our guys are enjoying it. They're doing a really good job at it.
From a pass rush standpoint, is it producing the results you guys hoped?
Based on what we're doing, yes, you know, and how you generate that pass rush. So, obviously, the first thing is to stop the run, and then you're going to get after the quarterback as well, like you just said. And the guys are doing a really good job. They're transitioning well in everything that we ask them to do.
Are you guys in a better position personnel-wise to do more fronts than maybe you were last year?
Yes, I would agree with that, absolutely. Personnel-wise, we are able to do that. That's why we're doing it. That's why we're doing it, because of the personnel that we do have.
How impressed have you been? I mean, you brought in a pretty big freshman DB class. How impressed have you been with all of them?
Very. Those guys are as advertised. They're good football players. Very, very good football players, and doing a good job, and has created a competition in our room that's making everybody take their game to another level. So, very impressed.
Kind of looking at the big picture, last year to now, what's the biggest difference?
One, have more defensive backs, being a defensive back coach. We have more, and they're really good football players. The best defensive back class that I've ever been a part of as a coach that just came in this year. And so that's how impressive those guys are, along with the guys we already had. So, again, having that depth in that room really helps out.
You mentioned the depth, but the competition that goes along with it, with that talented freshman class, how fun has that been to kind of see that develop?
Oh, very fun. It's been great because the older guys, they okay, I got to take my game up, okay? And so they're responding as well. And the young guys aren't backing down. So it's awesome. Because at the end, we're all one group. We're all a family, and we want to all succeed. So you're doing a great job.
With that, Coach Higgins back here, have you seen this allowing them to come in and, you know, immediately have an impact on you? Was it
their
mentality, or was it just they're just that talented?
A mentality. You know, we knew that in recruiting, that those guys were those type of guys mentally. So they came in, they not cocky, but confident, you know, in what they can do, and that's what they're showing right now.
And their understanding of the game, where is that compared to a lot of freshmen you've seen?
Really well. Their high school coaches, they did a good job with them. And then you got all this 7-on-7 stuff going on. So if you get connected with the right people, you get a good understanding of pass coverage and the run game and everything. So they're doing a great job.
What led to the decision to transition LeVon to the back end of the defense?
We feel like he's a guy that can be more, say, on the next level. They're getting longer on the edges, right? And on the next level, which is where he wants to go. They're getting longer in college on the edges, outside receivers. So we feel like putting him inside gives him a better chance to showcase his skills as a safety and kicking down on the slot, playing over the slot like he would be able to do on the next level versus a Edelman-type guy or something like that. So that was the thought process behind it.
A couple of your players talk about how versatility is key, you know, to survive as a player. I know switching and becoming more multiple is obviously about utilizing what you have, but is preparing them for that next level, like, in the back of your mind?
That's kind of in the back of our mind, but the main thing is get us right. And we teach them along the way and give them things that will help them for the next level, just by how we coach and who we talk to in the offseason and things like that, because we know that's where they strive to be. So we just try to give them every tool that they can have to help them prepare to go to the next level.
You've had some players kind of go from defensive end to like the rush linebacker. You've had some go from inside linebacker to that rush linebacker. How have you seen them in 2 weeks kind of adapt to their new role?
Absolutely, doing a really good job. And again, we went through the personnel. Who do we think could do this, do that, this, that, and the other? Who can stand up, keep their hand in the dirt? And they're proving out to show that feel like we were right about what we're doing.
Does the defense almost feel like it's a bit under the radar at times? Because outside the world, at least where we live in, let's just talk about this offense. What's it going to look like? You know, all the questions seem to be.
Keep it going. That's good. Perfect. That's all we have. We're going to leave it at that. Offense is doing great. Coach Browse does a great job. And that's awesome.
Do you get the sense, though, how hungry that defense might be, or just in general, this football team, to kind of show up?
They're ready to go. They'll be ready to go in 2 weeks, or less than 2 weeks now. They'll be ready. Promise you.
Coach, I know you've looked a little ahead to Boise State. What are they going to bring to the table offensively that'll challenge you guys?
Discipline, run game. They got the whole offensive line back. They're going to be very disciplined and poised. We got to be disciplined and poised and be in our gaps, do all the little things right, because that's what they're going to do. And it's going to be a good football game.
What gives you that confidence that you can say
that? Because of how they've worked this offseason and the chase. Spring ball, through summer workouts, and now fall camp. It's how they're working. Their mindset has changed, and everybody's pushing forward, trying to get better every day.
You see a different hunger from these guys this year, or maybe a different comfort level? Or
probably a little bit of both. You know, obviously we all get comfortable with one another after a year being together, and just a hunger for not wanting to do what happened in the past.
Maturity in college kids doesn't always go together, but do you think there's a level of maturity about this team because of the adversity that they've been through?
I think so. It drew us closer together, I think. And you can feel the bond even closer amongst the players and the coaches. So I think we're in a good place right now.
There's been a little buzz about Travis Jay early, obviously phenomenal athlete out of Madison. What is he, I mean, versatility-wise, is he a guy you can line up anywhere in the backfield?
Travis is a good football player. He's one of those guys that naturally understands sport. And what I mean by that, even as a basketball player, when you watch him play basketball, he understands what people are supposed to be. In football, okay, I'm here. He understands the big picture, not just his position. And that always allows you to succeed in anything that you do on the football field.
You've coached a lot of guys back there. How rare is that guy to have that extra sense out there?
Oh, you're right. It is rare because some guys just get locked in on their position. And so he's a guy that, like I said, can see it all, see the big picture, and knows where he fits and make plays because of it.
Thanks,
Coach. With the changes made in the